Welcome to Law Excellence. Today we are going to have a session on questions of the week. Here we have list of news items for the first 1 week. In the exam point of view, how the questions may ask, we will try to practice many questions on this news. Our main agenda is to accumulate the knowledge and news items, peripheral areas, how the question may ask, and we have to avoid small mistakes. Let's start with first news. Konkan 18. Why it is in the news? It is a naval exercise between India and United Kingdom, UK. This was held in Goa. This exercise was started in 2004 and then it was keep continuing. And this exercise main aim is to get it mutual benefit from each other and get experience and use it for the cooperation between both the countries. So source is Economic Times and topic comes to international relations. And also you can study in the security issues. HMS Dragon, we can see here, this reach to Konkan base for the military exercise. Let's practice one question. Which of the following true regarding Konkan 18? So it is the military exercise between India and Japan. And second statement is bilateral Konkan exercise was started in 2004. So here statement 2 only correct. Why? Because India and UK, United Kingdom, not the Japan. So here next topic, Dudhwa Tiger Reserve, why it is in the news? Recently, this reserve and Sashastra Seema Bal joined hands to provide security to this forest and rich wildlife. So we can, this source is Hindu, and we can study this topic in environment and conservation. So the question how it may ask. So first we have to know that this tiger reserve, where it is geographically located, and is there any rivers or any other significant important is there, we have to study those. So we can see here Dudhwa Tiger Reserve, it is just between UP and Nepal border here. So let's practice one question on this Dudhwa Tiger Reserve. Which of the following true regarding the Dudhwa Tiger Reserve? First statement, it is protected area in Uttar Pradesh and bordered with Nepal. And second statement, there are Suheli Mohana streams, that means rivers, that flow through this park. These are the tributary of the Ghaghra River. So here both the statements are correct. Let's go through another question. Which of the following statement regarding Sashastra Seema Bal? So first statement is this Sashastra Seema Bal is also known as Special Service Bureau, set up in 1963. The following Indo-China war. And the second statement is the primary task of this force was to provide armored support for research and analysis wing, that was a foreign intelligence agency, and it is a secondary objective to inculcate feeling of the national belonging in the border population. So here both the statements are correct. Here why we are studying this Sashastra Seema Bal? Because it is giving protection to Dudhwa Tiger Reserve. So let's go through Sashastra Seema Bal very brief little. And it is a central armored police force, and it is comes under the Home Affairs, Ministry of Home Affairs. And prior to this 2001, it was called Special Service Bureau, and it was established in 1963. Its headquarters is New Delhi. Its motto is service, security and brotherhood. So let's go through another topic, Sea of Azov, why it is in the news. Recently, Russia captured 3 Ukraine naval ships and over 20 crew members due to dispute between the Russia and Ukraine. This was a issue for the past few years, it was in issue. Let us see here how the map it is. And we can see here, this is the Ukraine. And it is here Sea of Azov, and this is the Russia border, and this is the Crimea where dispute was started, and Russia occupied this forcefully. So and here Black Sea is also there. So let's practice a question on Sea of Azov. Which of the following countries are border to the Sea of Azov? The border is Turkey, Ukraine, Russia, Crimea. So here answer goes to all are correct. Let's practice next question. Which of the following countries are border to the Black Sea? So here the first statement is Azerbaijan is the border, and second is Armenia is the border, and third Georgia is the border, and fourth Ukraine, and fifth is Russia. So here correct option is Georgia, Ukraine, Russia. So answer goes to C. This is not border. So if we see clearly Black Sea, the Georgia is here and Russia is here, Ukraine is here. Here we can see this is Azerbaijan and this is Armenia. So here we have to remember the mnemonics RRB UZ training. So here R means Russia, another R means Romania, and B means Bulgaria, and U means Ukraine, and G means Georgia, and T means Turkey. Let us go through next to Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle PSLV-C43. Why it is in the news? Recently ISRO launched successfully 31 satellites from this Satish Dhawan Space Center, Sriharikota. The source is PIB, and we can study this topic in science and technology, space technology. So in the exam point of view, its significance and whether we have to go through. So this is PSLV-C43. Here, what is the significance of this launching vehicle? So ISIS is the one satellite they launched. Its full form is Hyperspectral Imaging Satellite. So it is an Earth observatory satellite. Its lifetime is 5 years. And satellites are from Australia, Colombia, Malaysia and Spain. So please remember these countries. This is the first time from these countries we launched it from the PSLV-C43. So this is the part of the Antrix Corporation Limited and customers, because we are providing this kind of service to the foreign countries also, and we are launching their satellites. So it is a commercial purpose, and we will get the money from that, and it will help for the current account deficit. So what is the primary goal of the ISIS satellite? So to study the Earth surface, both visible and near infrared and shortwave infrared regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. So whatever the data is coming from the satellite, we will use for various applications: agriculture and forestry, soil, geographical environment and coastal zones and inland waterways and many more things. Earlier questions of the week also we have discussed the PSLV, and it is a third generation launching vehicle. Last week we discussed about PSLV and GSLV, what is the differences. So here it is the four stage launching vehicle. So here in this launching vehicle, first stage is solid motors, and second stage is liquid stage, and third stage is solid again, and fourth stage is liquid alternative. So this was used in the Chandrayaan 1 2008 and Mars Orbiter 2013. So please remember these two also. Practice one question on ISIS. So which of the following true regarding the ISIS satellite? So it is a communication satellite, and the second is satellites are from Australia, Colombia, Malaysia and Spain, were flown abroad. This is the first time. So here the statement is correct and this is wrong, because it is not the communication satellite, it is a Earth observatory satellite. So answer is 2 only. 2018 G20 summit. Why it is in the news? 2018 G20 summit is being held in the city Buenos Aires. It is the capital city of the Argentina. It is in South America. And these 19 leaders were attended here. It is the biggest economic summit, and representatives across the European Union, and it was held in November 18. It is, the source is Hindu, and it is a part of the international bodies you can study. We can also study this in the geography point of view. Geographically, Argentina, where it is located, that is in the exam point of view also important. Let us see Argentina where geographically located in map. In South America, you can see here it is located. In the exam point of view, we have to look that equator, which is passing through which countries. That is our observation. And we can see here two countries are landlocked. They are Paraguay and this is Bolivia. Here if you see the Argentina clearly, so the Tropic of Capricorn passes through Chile, Argentina, Paraguay, Brazil. So that means 1, 2, 3, 4 countries. Topic of Capricorn process. Now why we have to study? Because here G20 summit held, so in that geography perspective also we have to study all those things. Apart from this, we will study many more things in the geography climate point of view, warm currents and cold currents. These are If we see the political map of the Argentina, the capital is Buenos Aires, and the neighbor countries are, one is Uruguay and Paraguay, and Bolivia, Chile, Brazil. So here 5 countries are border with Argentina. If we see the physical map of the Argentina, just we can see the plains, Chaco plains here, and pampas, grasslands, and this is the Patagonia plateau. And we can see that the longest mountain in the world, that is Andes mountain. You can see this is the longest mountain in the world. Highest mountain in the world, Everest, and longest mountain, Andes mountain. So let's practice few questions on G20 summit. And which of the following true regarding the G20 summit? So it is the 13th meeting of the group of 20, and it is the first G20 summit to host in South America. So yes, it is the first time in South America hosted. So both are correct. Let's go through brief about G20. What is G20 and when it is formed? So it was formed in 1999. So it is international forum and forum of the governments and central bank governors. So some of the facts here, G20 economies, we can see that it is collective just 20 countries. It contributes 85% of the world GDP and also 80% of the world trade also. The main objective is to tackle any problems, challenges facing the world. So what exactly these do? They go with the studying, reviewing, promoting high level discussions, policy issues pertaining to this international financial stability, any issues are there like that. And also it will go through payment problem issues and financial markets, is there how to coordinate monetary, fiscal and financial policies. So ultimately this forum seeks to address the issues. It goes behind some responsibilities of any particular organization. So in these member countries, 19 individual countries and one European Union. Here we can see Shaktikant Das. He is the former secretary and Department of Economic Affairs, has been appointed as the India's G20 Sherpa till December 31, 2018. So what is this Sherpa? It is a person representative of the leaders of the member country in the international summit meeting, like even G8 or G20 or nuclear summit, whatever the summits happens, this Sherpa is the representative to that. So let's practice one question. Which of the following statements true regarding the G20 summit? And first statement goes to here, G20 has no permanent staff of its own, and it has chairmanship rotates annually between nations divided into regional groups. Second statement, the first G20 summit was held in Berlin in 1999 and was hosted by the finance ministers of the German and Canada. So yes, both our statements are correct. Here there is no permanent staff of its own. You remember this 1999 first summit is in Berlin. Another question we will practice. Recently G20 summit regarding this, which of the following true? So first statement is 2017 G20 summit was held at Germany, Hamburg. And the second statement is 2018 summit was held at Buenos Aires, Argentina. Third statement is 2019 summit, where it will be held? So Osaka, it is in Japan. So all the statements are correct. Please remember this. And next summit will be in Japan. And this year, recently, just last week, it was held in Buenos Aires, Argentina. Last year, Hamburg, Germany. So in the Argentina, it was the first summit hosted in South America. It was held on 30 November to December 1st. So Constitution Day, so why it is in the news? Recently, we celebrated every year November 26 as our Constitutional Day, as we adapted our Constitution on that particular this day. So, and this Constitution came into effect on January 26, 1950. The source is Hindu, and we can study this topic in the Polity and Constitution, Evolution of the Constitution. Here we'll start some add-on points regarding this, and the drafting committee chairman is Ambedkar, as you all know, and this Constitutional Day is a tribute to Ambedkar also. And before that, earlier this day was commemorated as 26 as National Law Day. Actually earlier, here this year celebration, what is the importance? Actually this time Constitution will be made available to the Braille and blind people also. So this who made this effort? Buddhist Association, that is Savvy Foundation and Swagat Torat. So let's practice one question. Consider the following statements. Janagana Mana adapted as a national anthem on 26th January 1950. And second statement is national flag of India and was adopted before independence. And third statement is Constituent Assembly was formed on 26 November 1946. Here answer is 2 and 3. This is wrong because it is 24th January they adopted this one. And national flag also July 22nd 1947 we adopted this national flag also before independence only. So add on points here is Janagana Mana, it is a national anthem of India. It was originally in Bengal and it was written by the Rabindranath Tagore and officially it adopted in January 24, 1950 and national flag on 22nd July 1947, just few days before the independence. Next up here is Andaman and Nicobar Island, why it is in the news. Recently, Geographical Survey of India titled Faunal Diversity of Biogeographical Zones, Islands of India. So this is the first time database for all flora and fauna found in island is. So it told that 11,009. So the source is Hindu and topic we can study in the environment conservation. If we add on points here, the what documents is telling, this island consists of only 1/4 of the geographical area, but it has more than 10% of the flora. Here another topic is first Amur falcon, why is in the news. So here Amur falcon flies every year northeast regions like Nagaland, Manipur, where it comes from, it migrates from the Siberian China. So what is the news, why it is in Doyang reservoir in Nagaland, one district is there. So more than millions of these Amur falcons gathering here, largest congregation in the world falcon. So what happened this year, this Doyang reservoir was designed as an important bird area. So you have to remember this important bird area they designated it as. So birds live in India and around in the December month and fly over back over the Indian Ocean towards to Africa later. So where is the source is the like Hindu and we can study it in the environment area. Add on points is the Eco Club also started in this particular region by the Bombay Natural History of Society. So please remember that this society was asked in UPSC question earlier, previous question. Why they started this club? Because to help this to the students to learn the different kinds of flora and to learn them and to for the purpose of conservation. So Tidli cyclone, why it is in the news recently? So this cyclone was hit the devastated in Odisha coast. So what is in, why it is in the news? There was an organization called Regional Integrated Multi-Hazard Early Warning System. So it is working for intergovernmental organization it is, and it is, so what it said is it told that Tilti is a rarest cyclone. So here this is source is Hindu and we can study it in the climate and geography perspective and also disaster management area time also we can study it. So here before studying about this organization, we will study about Titli, how these kind of names are giving, who is giving and why you are keeping this Titli names and all. So here we can see this, that today this whatever the cyclone came and hit in the Odisha coast, the name given as Titli. And if another cyclone, if it come in the Bay of Bengal region, the name will come to Gaza and then to another. So there is a organization and there are many countries, few countries. They give on the rotation basis. These are the Indian Ocean neighbor countries. So they give the names and name will be given on rotation basis. So why we are giving this kind of name, because just for the easy communication and for the forecasters and general public and to avoid some confusion regarding this. So who has this authority to give this kind of names? Already there are 8 in Northern Indian Ocean countries are there, like Bangladesh, India, Maldives, Myanmar, Oman, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Thailand. These 8 countries, they give the names, 64 names they have given. So those names will be chosen by the on rotation basis by the Indian Meteorological Department. When this was started, after the devastation happened 2004, in the cyclone, tropical cyclone in Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea. Since then, we are using this. So here, titli is meaning butterfly, and it is a surprise, delicate names. And who is given this name? So it was name is given by the Pakistan. So let's start few questions regarding this news. And regional integrated multi-hazard early warning system. So what is this? This is a intergovernmental body registered under United Nations, and it is registered with the United Nations in 2009. And this is owned and managed by 45 countries. So India is the chairman of this body, and it is operates from the regional early warning center. Where it is this regional early warning center? Where it is located in Thailand. One campus is there, Asian Institute of Technology, Pathumthani. So there, this is the regional center we have, and we are operating from here. So when this body is evolved, aftermath of the Indian Ocean tsunami 2004, this body has evolved. You can see these rhyme countries. So 45 countries you can see here, all the countries: Madagascar, Mozambique, Tanzania, Kenya, Somalia, Yemen, Pakistan, India, Uzbekistan, Myanmar, Bangladesh, Thailand, Indonesia, and Singapore, Cambodia, Philippines, China, Papua New Guinea, all these things. So let's practice one question. Which of the following true regarding the rhyme countries? The first statement is rhymes was established on 30 April 2009 and was registered with the United Nations on 1st July 2009. The second statement is it operates from the regional early warning center. Center is located at campus of the Asian Institute of Technology in Pathumthani, Thailand. So both statements are correct here. Next question we practice. Which of the following statement true regarding the regional integrated multi-hazard early warning system? The first statement is it is intergovernmental body registered with the United Nations, and it is owned and managed by 45 collaborated countries in Asia Pacific and Africa. So both are correct. Let's go through another topic, Kangaja village. So why it is in the news? This village is located in Kerala, and why it is in the news? Because it is they conducted some different self-defense training program. In this, many women are attended. Around 7,800 women attended here. Here just we have to remember this is one Kangaja, and it is located in Kerala. So this source is Hindu, and we can study this topic in women safety and related issues. So another topic is right to issue. Why it is in the news? Here Supreme Court said that in the recent order, we can have right to resign any job, and we cannot be forced to continue the job. So recommendations of the Swaminathan committee. So why it is in the news, we can say, because recently thousands of farmers, they started gathered in Jantar Mantar, New Delhi, demanding loan waivers and better price for their produce just before election campaigns. So this we can study. This source is Indian Express, and topic is agriculture issues. Let's practice one related to these issues. Which of the following true regarding the National Commission on Farmers? So first statement is it was constituted on November 18, 2004 under the chairmanship of M.S. Swaminathan. In the second statement, the report said that their suggestion of the one of the goal was faster and more inclusive growth that was envisaged in the 11th five-year plan. So both statements are correct here. So this commission also come up with many suggestions also. Here next topic is Sustainable Blue Economy Conference. Why it is in the news? Recently, first Sustainable Blue Economy Conference was held at Nairobi, capital of Kenya. So it is in the South America. And who is organized this? This is organized by the Japan and Canada. So here India is also endorsed in this part of the growth for the Sustainable Blue Economy. And it is inclusive and people-centered manner through framework of Indian Ocean Rim Association. So here, the source is PIB, Press Information Bureau, and the topic we can study in the environment conservation and also agriculture related. So Kenya, Nairobi, where it was Sustainable Development Blue Economy Conference was held. And we have to see here which countries in the exam perspective we have to see. What is the significance of this Kenya geographically? Is there any? And also here we can see that this is the equator is going on. So we can see clearly Gabon, Congo, and Democratic Republic of Congo, and Kenya and Somalia, and here touches Uganda also small. Total 6 countries equator is going on. So let's practice one question. Which of the following true regarding equator passes through African continents? So Gabon, Republic of Congo, the Democratic Republic of Congo, Uganda, Kenya, Somalia, Tanzania. So it is clearly said that Tanzania is not going. So here option. So option is D. So in the context of Sustainable Blue Economy Conference, so we are also studying the Indian Ocean Rim Association. So Indian Ocean Rim Association is a dynamic organization. In this 22 members are there and 9 dialogue partners. We can see here with this color, green color is 22 countries. You can see here, and the dialogue partners 9 are with other color here. The main intention is to get the mutual benefit from regional cooperation through consensus. Also non-intrusive approach. So here we add on points. What is the Indian Ocean Rim Association? What is the objective and priority areas to promote the sustainable and balanced development in this region, member states and all, and also to promote liberalization and provide enhance the flow of goods, services, investment and technology within the Indian Ocean Rim region. So this Indian Ocean Rim Association identified 6 priority areas: maritime security, trade and investment and fisheries, disaster risk reduction, and academic and scientific cooperation, and tourism promotion and cultural exchange. This is the structure of this Indian Ocean Rim Association. It is a FX body of the all foreign ministers meet annually. Is there any significance in this present year? Republic of South Africa assumed the role of 2017 to 2019, followed by United Arab Emirates. Recently, Indian Ocean Rim Association 20th summit was held in Indonesia, March. So as per the Indian Ocean Rim Association, there is the 2 posts are there, chair and vice chair on behalf of the members. So this will be the 2 years post, and once vice chair and chair, they take over and they will become the chairman of the Indian Ocean Rim Association. Presently vice chair is UAE and vice chairman is Bangladesh. So once they complete the 2 year and they will become the chairman. So Bangladesh will become chairman of Indian Ocean Region Association October 2021 only, after 2 years of this post. Here we have to remember 18th Indian Ocean Regional Council of Ministers meeting that was held in Durban, South Africa. So currently chair is South Africa and vice chair is UAE. So 18th Indian Ocean Regional Association Council meeting was held in Durban, South Africa. So what is the outcome of this? The outcomes are Maldives was accepted as the 22nd member of this Indian Ocean region. Maldives was the 22nd in this present. We have to remember this. And Myanmar, you can see here, Myanmar is not the member of the Indian Ocean region. Why they are not accepted? Because there was a lack of consensus between the and opposed by the South Africa. And here outcome is Bangladesh will host 3rd Indian Ocean Blue Economy Ministerial Conference in Dhaka in September 2019, next year. And also first ever ministerial level conference will be organized by this Bangladesh. So Bangladesh will organize next 3rd Blue Economy Ministerial Conference. So third outcome is, so they adopted declaration on commemoration of Nelson Mandela and Itiquin Communique. Fourth outcome is document also told that to enhance cooperation among the 22 members. So that means we have to remember the 22 countries of the Indian Ocean Region Rim Association, 22 countries, and contribute more in ensuring the feasible and stable and sustainable region. So let's practice one question. Which of the following statements is true regarding the 18th Indian Ocean Rim Association? So it was held in first statement Durban, South Africa in November 2, 2018. Recently it was held there, 18th summit. Before that means it was held in the Indonesia. So second statement is Maldives and Myanmar was accepted as the 22nd and 23rd members of the Indian Ocean region. So earlier we have discussed that. So here clearly it is telling the only first statement is correct. Second statement is wrong because Myanmar was not accepted as the 23rd member because South Africa was opposed, due to its mutual consensus or some other issues. Myanmar membership proposal was not approved due to lack of consensus. So let's practice which of the following true regarding the Sustainable Blue Economy Conference. The first statement is it is the first global conference on sustainable blue economy, and third statement is it is held in Nairobi, capital of Kenya. It was organized by Kenya and co-hosted by the Japan and Canada. So all the statements are correct. So next question is which of the following statement true regarding the Indian Ocean Rim Association. So it is intergovernmental organization, was established in on 7 March 1997. And for second statement is the vision of this IORA is originated during the visit by the Nelson Mandela of South Africa to India in 1995. Third statement is IORA's FX body is Council of Foreign Ministers, which meet annually. So all the statements are correct. Let's practice one more question. Which of the following statements true regarding the IORA? The first statement is the coordinating secretary of the IORA is located at Eben, Mauritius. So coordinating secretary is located at Eben, Mauritius. The second statement is association comprises 21 members of the 7 dialogue partners. Also Indian Ocean Tourism Organization and Indian Ocean Research Group also has the observer status. So here first statement is correct, second statement is wrong, because here 22 members recently, Maldives was the 22nd, Maldives. So 22nd, so here first statement is only correct. So the remaining all are correct only. So AIDS, why it is in the news? Recently December 1st we celebrated AIDS Day. So it is designated since 1988, and why it is, because it is a awareness program of the AIDS. So it was caused by the spread of HIV infection. The source is Hindu, and we can study it in the topic health related issues. Here next topic is UNESCO, which means United Nations Education and Scientific and Cultural Organization, added RIGE to its list of cultural institution to protect and preserve this. So why it is in the news? Because this UNESCO added this RIGE, added as a list to its list of cultural institution and protection and preserve. So source is Hindu, and we can study this topic in the history culture area. So let's practice one question on RIGE. So which of the following true regarding the RIGE? It is a Jamaican music originated from the marginalized group, mainly in Western Kingston. So second statement is it was started out as a voice of marginalized, but it is played and embraced by the wild cross sections of the society, including gender, ethnic and religious, all groups. First it was marginalized voice. So both are correct. Next we have to remember it is a Jamaican music. So here add on points regarding the UNESCO's list of intangible cultural is. So what is this? This intangible cultural list is established in 2008. It is when on the convention on safeguarding the intangible cultural heritages. From India perspective, what are the intangible cultural heritages were added in this list? There are many: Vedic chanting, Ram Leela, Kuttayam, Ramman, Mudiyettu, Kalbelia, Cho dance, Buddhist chanting of Ladakh, Sankirtana, Yoga, Navroz, Kumbh Mela, all are added in this list. So latest in the exam point of what they were added, 2007 Kumbh Mela was added in the intangible, and 2016 Navroz was added, 2016 again Yoga, 2014 and there was traditional brass coffer, so making that is in Punjab, and 2013 it is Sankirtana, it is a ritual singing and drumming and dancing in Manipur, Sankirtana. So please remember these latest information regarding exam point of view. So next topic is Global Wage Report 2018-19. So why it is in the news? Recently International Labour Organization was released this report 2018-19. So what this report is telling? So women are paid unequally in India compared to men, and it is almost women are paid 34% less than men. So the source is Hindu, and we can study this topic in the women related issues. The next topic is Saubhagya, why it is in the news. Recently 8 states achieved 100% household electrification under this scheme, especially in the Madhya Pradesh, Tripura, Bihar, Jammu Kashmir, Mizoram, Sikkim, Telangana and West Bengal. So government was committed to give 24/7 electricity to all by 31st March 2019. That means only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 states out of all states achieved this kind. So source is PIB, and we can study this in the infrastructure energy welfare schemes. So some add-on points here regarding Saubhagya. It is a Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana. So what is the objective is to provide access electricity connection to all households, and also provide subsidy on equipments such as transformers, wires and meters. So this scheme is come under the Ministry of Power, and they are the implementing authority, and power connection will be provided in both rural and urban area under this scheme. And it is launched on the occasion of the Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyaya on 21st December as his birth anniversary. So next topic we'll go through, that is heli clinic or helicopter clinics. Why it is in the news? Recently Union Minister, they come up with this for remote areas to provide specialized medical care to the people living in the inaccessible areas, that is hilly terrains, like you can see in the Jammu, Kashmir and Northeast states. So the topic is taken from the PIB, and you can study it in the health related issues and government policies. So emergency response support system, recently why it is in the news? Because Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh launched this emergency response support system in Himachal Pradesh. So source is PIB, and we can study this topic in women related issues. Here add-on points is Himachal Pradesh is the first state to launch this Pan India Single Emergency. So the number is 112, and this number will connect to police, fire and health and other helplines through emergency response center. Central government has allocated 321 crore under this Nirbhaya fund for implementation of this project. Let's practice one question regarding this. Which of the following true regarding the Nirbhaya fund? So it can be utilized for the project for women safety and security, and it is administered by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. So here only first statement is correct, and this is the second statement is wrong, because it is administered by the Ministry of Finance, and monitoring is the Ministry of Women and Child. Administer is different and monitoring is different. Administer comes under the Ministry of Finance, so please remember this. And the answer is only one, so here forgot to give the options. Here some add-on points regarding the Nirbhaya fund. So why this is established? To eradicate the violence against the women and girl. So it is administered by the Ministry of Economic Affairs and Finance, and it is nodal agent is Ministry of Women and Child Development. Please remember this. So here whatever the projects related to women safety and security related projects are there, so this point will be used in this. So let's discuss another topic, that is Atomic Energy Regulatory Board, why it is in the news. Recently Union Government appointed another scientist, Nageswar Rao Gunturu, as the chairman of this Atomic Energy Regulatory Board. Please remember. So let's add on some points regarding the Atomic Energy Regulatory Board. So when was it was established? 1983 by the President, under the Act of Atomic Energy Act 1962 by the President. And what it is the power given to carry out certain regulatory and safety functions under this act. So here we can see that we have to remember 1983. It is related to nuclear power, and headquarters is Mumbai. Inclusive Wealth Report 2018. Why it is in the news? Inclusive Wealth Index. So it is a part of Inclusive Wealth Report, as it is released by the United Nations Environment and other. So another topic, Prevention of Corruption Act, why it is in the news? Recently Supreme Court ordered the government to respond for some petitions challenging in the Supreme Court, because government come up with trying to amend Prevention of Corruption Act. So this is Hindu and governance point of view, you can study this corruption point of view. So here this act, what it is, so introduction of section 17A1, what it says it. There is need a prior permission for investigation of corruption offences. So from the government, we need to take the permission from the government for any investigation. That is introducing. And second one is removing section 13(1)(d)(2). So what it, criminal misconduct from the act. So what it is saying, earlier it was made it offence for public servants to abuse his position for taking any money or advantages. So next topic is International Day for Elimination of Violence against Women. So why it is in the news? So International Day for Elimination of Violence Against Women is observed on 25th November. Every year we celebrate. Why it is? To give awareness about the violence against the woman and girl, and also end the violence against the woman. And it seeks to provide prevention and possible to any other actions. Theme of this year is Orange the World, Hear Me Too. The source is Hindu and Women Related Issues topic. We can study this. Here add-on points related to International Day for Elimination of Violence Against Women is, it is constituted by the United Nations General Assembly in December 1999. So the day is commemorated by the Mirabal sisters, who were political activists from Dominican Republic. So they were brutally assassinated during the Rafael Trujillo dictatorship 1930 and 1961. Let's practice one question. Which of the following true regarding International Day for Elimination of Violence Against the Woman? So first statement is, was celebrated on November 25th. And the second statement is, it was instituted by United Nations General Assembly in 1999. So both are correct. Thank you, friends. All the best.